Okay, good morning to all of you. I welcome you in Mr. Khan Academy. Today we are going to start our seventh video in second series, that is 2.7 Principle of Operation of Stepper Motor. And also we are going to cover a small bit under this same video, that is a step angle. What exactly is a step angle? How to calculate the step angle? All these things we are going to cover in last two slides. Before starting this two video, you can check my last two previous videos, that is 2.5 Servo Amplifier and DC Motor Service Drive. And also you can check 2.6 Characteristics and Classification of Stepper Motor. The links of these two videos are available over here. Right side, topmost corner, the card icon is there. Yahan pe aap dekh sakte. If it is not visible for desktop user, just move your cursor. By moving the cursor over here, the icon will be appeared and you can click here and all the videos, previous videos links will be available over here. One more thing important, if you are my new viewers, अगर अभी तक आपने मेरा चैनल सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया है देन प्लीज सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल टू मोटिवेट मी टू मेक सच वीडियो इन फ्यूचर आल्सो ऑन मेकाट्रॉनिक्स टॉपिक और अदर टॉपिक्स आल्सो एंड हिट द लाइक बटन अगर आपको अच्छा लगा होगा तो एंड शेयर दिस वीडियो विद योर फ्रेंड्स आल्सो दोज हु नीड इट एंड इफ यू हैव एनी सजेशन फीडबैक प्लीज मेंशन इन कमेंट बॉक्स बिफोर स्टार्टिंग एवरी वीडियो जस्ट वी विल सी हाउ मेनी टॉपिक्स वी कवर टिल नाउ इन सेकेंड सीरीज In second series, as I said in 2.0, all these topics I'm going to cover. Till now I covered the 2.1 principal operation of DC motor, my first video in second series. Second video, modeling of DC motor behavior. Third, heat dissipation in DC motor and velocity profile optimization. Fourth, inertia matching. And fifth, servo amplifier and DC motor servo drive. And last, just I recently uploaded the videos, characteristic and classification of stepper motor. You can check all these videos which is available on my channel. For that you need to click on subscribe channel or you can check over here in the card icon. The links are available last 5 videos. And in this video, as I said, I'm going to cover principle of operation of stepper motor and step angles. And in future I'm going to cover the electrical motor of energized coil, dry methods, AC induction motor, that is 3-phase motor, and moist coil actuators. If you want updates of all these future videos, for that purpose you need to hit the subscribe button. Then please hit the subscribe button. Let's start principal operation of stepper motor. The stepper motor can be operated in one of the three modes. Means in these three modes only the stepper motor can operate. That is a full step, okay, half step, and micro step. In the full step mode, all motor windings are energized simultaneously. An input pulse switches current polarity in a winding and advance the rotor by its inherent step angles. Means whatever the pulse we are applied to the motor according to that pulse switches, the motor will be operate and it reorient the rotor by which we are getting the step angle in a full step mode. Means single coils will be energized simultaneously and by changing the polarity also, because of that rotor will be rotated and we are getting the step. That is the working principle of full step mode. In the case of half step mode, the windings are energized so that within the three step sequence, only one winding is energized in a second step. A strong step followed by a weak step result in a lower torque at the low step rates, but in a slightly higher torque at the high step rates. But in this case, we are energizing first two step, then single winding, again two winding, then single winding. Like this sequence will be there. Because of that, we are getting half step mode. In the full step mode, one phase energized single time, but in the half step mode, one phase, then two phase, and again one phase. Like this sequence is there. Might be you are not getting exactly what I am explaining over here, but when I am explaining in diagram, then you understand what exactly is the difference between full step and half step mode. We are not going to cover the micro step. Only we are going to cover in this video full step and half step mode. Now the principle, first we are studying the variable reluctance motor. Means there are various type of stepper motors are there, variable reluctance, permanent magnet, hybrid motor, linear motor. For all this detail, you need to check my 2.6 video which is available on my channel and it is also available in this card icon. You can click here and you can check first that video and then go with this video, then and then only you understand what is the principle operation of all various stepper motors. Now we are starting with the first motor, that is variable reluctance. The principle operation of VR, that is a variable reluctance stepper motor, is based on the principle of minimum reluctance. okay, whereby the rotor always seeks to reorient itself at the stable position by finding the shortest magnetic path with the smallest air gap. Means here what we exactly are doing, as I said, when we are energizing the single state, then because of that a single phase one magnetic flux line will be generated, and that magnetic flux will be reorient the rotor with the help of finding the smallest air gap, and we are getting the first state. Thus the rotor of the variable network seeks the stable position. Okay, might we are not getting exactly what I am explaining in this word. Let's check in the diagram what exactly is their variable networks. In this case, I am going to cover this type of first various stepper motors are there, variable returns, but for the explaining the principal operation, we are going to cover we will refer this diagram. This diagram is used for number of rotors. Here are the six. This is a rotor, this is a stator, outside is a stator, inside this rotor. In the rotor, number of these are 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and number of stator these are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Various combination tits of number stator and rotors are available based on their various varieties. We are getting the variable reference also, but here for explanation we are going to we are taking the example of this motor. First we will cover the full step, how the full step occurs, full step operation takes place. Now other operations are then specification also there in the number of phases. Here four phases are there. How we can say the four phases? Because A and A prime, these two teeth are connected with the single winding. See, the winding started from here, and here we are winding the winding for the first teeth, that A, and then it's come over here, the A prime again is winding, and it's come down. Means here positive, and here if we are connected negative, then this A and A prime coil will be energized. This is the first phase. Similarly, B and B prime, the connectivity is not shown, only connective A and A prime shown. The same connectivity will be there for B and B prime, C, C prime, E, D prime. Because of that, here I am saying number of phases are 4. 4 phase stepper motor. The rotor pitch angle is 60 degree. Why 60 degree? The number of hits are 6. Number of hits are 6. And total, if we are dividing the 360 divided by 6, then we are getting angle 60 degree. Means angle between the pitch angle between two teeth in the rotor is 60 degree. Similarly, stator pitch angle between the stator two teeth, the angle is 45 degree, because 360 divided by 8, because 8 teeth are there in rotor. The number of step per revolution, it required 24 step to complete one step. How we are getting step 24 step? We'll see at the time of step angle. When we have explained the step angle, that time you come to know that from where I got this 24 value. And the step angle, that step angle is nothing but 360 divided by number of step, and here number of steps are 24, then 360 divided by 24, then for one step is when we are sending the one pulse signal to the stepper motor, I'm getting 15 degree angle rotation. And last, the number of stator teeth per phase, that is a 2, means for the single winding we require 2 teeth of stator. Okay, that is the specification of this stepper motor. And let's start principal operation of variable reactance, full step mode. Then let's assume initially I energize the A and A prime coin. As I energize the A and A prime coin that coil, then the magnetic flux will be passing from A, 1, 4 and A prime. It will be, we are getting the detained position, stable position. I didn't got any step angle. To get the first step angle, I need to switch the current from A to A prime to B and B prime. Means I send the signal pulse A to A prime to B, B prime. Then what will happen? The coil will be energized, the current will be passed. Because of that, magnetic flux will be generated. We are getting the magnetic coil line. It will find the shortest air angle. As I explained, the principal operation is minimum reluctance, and this is shortest air gap. And as B will be attract 2, B prime will be at track 5, and we are getting the first step angle, that is 15 degree angle. Similarly, it will be repeated, and we are getting first detained position. Similarly, it will be continue for the C. Now we will energize the C coil, C and C prime. As the C and C prime is energized, B and B is de-energized. We are not sending any signal to B and B prime. Now we are sending the signal C and C prime. Okay. As we are sending the signal C and C prime, all A, B and D's are off. Only C and C prime is on. Now magnetic flux will be passing from C, 3, 6 and C prime, and because of that the C will be at track 3, C prime will be at track 6, and we are getting second step angle 15 degree. again it will be from the d and d prime. Okay, the same magnetic flux will be generated and you are getting third step angle. And last, a and a prime magnetic flux will be generated, 2 and 5 will be come in a contact and it will attract, a will be attract to a prime of 5 and we are getting fourth step angle. Like this we are getting a b c d and again a. It will repeat again, we are getting next continuously step. This is the principle operation of full step mode. Now principle of operation of variable reactance, applying the same sequence in reverse force. Since reverse, we are getting counterclockwise, because whatever the whatever the explanation previously I explained, it is a counterclockwise. But for the if we are doing the reverse, A, D, C, B and again A, we are getting clockwise rotation. If we two adjacent phases, means two phases is simultaneously energized, an equilibrium position is created halfway between the two full state acquired by the exciting phase A, B separately. This process can be repeated for the remaining phases also, that is B, C, C, D and D, A. If the phase excitation sequence is A, D, C, B, D, A, C, A, B, D, B, C and A is executed in this sequence, if I energize the coil, the rotor makes the twice the number of counterclockwise moves as before. Means previously I think so I get the fourth step to come the one teeth again the same position previously, but in this case might be required the eighth step. This called as a half step mode. Again it is a confusing, might be you are not getting exactly what I'm explaining in terms of word. Now let's take the same previous diagram. We are taking the same example. Now A and A prime is energized, a signal I'm applying A and A prime, B, C, D's are off, because of that 1 and 4 are in single line. Now let's apply signal instead of B, now applying D, C. Okay, in various book they are explaining A, A, B, 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 C, C, D, C, C, D, C, D, A, B, like this sequence are there. I think so that sequence not working properly for this example. Same examples are there in that book, same diagram is there, same variable director motor they use, but the sequence are different. Then according to me the sequence will be after A, that is DC. Okay, as DC they are saying AB, but AB is not possible. The next possible combination is DC. If I energize after A DC, then what will happen? D to D prime and C to C prime, the magnetic flux will be generated. Because of that, the C will be attracted by D prime also, C prime also, and 3 attracted by D and C also. Because of that one, we are getting an equilibrium state. And because of that, I am getting 7.5 degree rotation, that is half step mode. Previously what happened, I am getting 15 degree rotation, but here as I energizing the two coils simultaneously at the same instant, I am getting half step mode, that is 7.5 degree. After that, now I am energizing the B, B and B prime. As I am energizing B and B prime, 7.5. Now next DA, D and A. If I am energizing the D and A, next 7.5, and C and C prime 9.5, A and A prime next 7.5, D and D prime next 7.5. Now next BC simultaneously two coils I am energizing 7.5. Last again finally A and A prime I am getting last stable version. Now here number of steps are required 8. Previous case I am required the 4 step, but here I required the 8 step. That is a benefits of half step angle. We are getting the half angle as compared to full step. The same principle operations are there for the permanent magnet also. Only difference is there in permanent magnet, the rotor having, instead of soft time I am using the permanent magnet button. Because of that I am getting some holding torque. If even though the load whatever the apply, if it is a the force exerted is less than holding torque, then I am getting the holding position of the rotor. That is the advantage of permanent magnet. But principle operation is similar as the variable reluctance. Then I'm not going to explain the permanent magnets. You can check the previous slide. The same concept is there for permanent magnet also. Only material of the rotary changes and I'm getting the holding torque in the case of permanent magnet. Principle operation is same. Only I'm going to explain the last principle of operation of hybrid motor. How hybrid motor is work. What is a hybrid motor? As I said, is a combination of variable reluctance and permanent magnet. Then here again, in the rotor side, I am getting the two curves in the shaft. The curves, two magnets are there. One is the north and one is the south pole. Okay, and rotor side, I'm using that only fourth. It's again the number of poles are there: A1, B1, A2, B2. Now principal operation. Now let's I'm applying the negative for A prime, A1, whatever the coils are there in A side, A1. Instead of A prime, I'm using the A1, A2 over here. Suppose A1, I'm applying the negative supply, and A2, I'm supplying the positive supply. Because of that, A1 will be negative, A2 will be positive. That is means A1 will be north side, A2 will be south. Then what will happen? I'm getting the stable position because north will be attracted south, and south will be attracted north. But when I'm sending the signal pulse instead of A1, A2, B1, B2, and B1 will be positive, I'm getting south pole. B2 will be negative, I'm getting north pole. Then what will happen? Whatever the tits are there, 1, 2, 3, these tits will be attract. As it is south, it will be north. This tit will be attract whatever the nearest tits are there. And here, as B2 is in north pole, then this south tit will be attracted over this pole. And I'm getting the one state. In the case of hybrid mode, a very fine, very micro step I'm getting over here in the case of hybrid mode. Then next, previously initially I applied the negative positive, but now applying the positive negative. As here I'm applying the positive, here I'm getting south pole. As I'm applying the negative, here I'm getting north pole. Then south pole will be attract the north pole tits, these three tits, and north pole will attract south pole, these three tits, and I'm getting nested. Again, I am changing the polarity. Instead of previously applied the positive negative, now I am applying the negative positive. I am getting the next step, and finally again I change the polarity negative positive. I am getting the final step. Like this rotation I am getting in the case of hybrid motor. The same principles are there like a variable reference. Only difference is there in that we are using the single teeth. Here number of teeth are more. Because of that we are getting very small step angles in the case of hybrid motor. Now last part, what is exactly the step angle? If you see the definition, the angular moment caused by the shaft when single electrical pulse applied to the motor. What exactly is this? The definition, as I explained over here, instead of A and A prime, now I'm supplying the signal to B and B prime. A, C, D are off. Only I'm supplying the electric signal to B and B prime, single signal. And what will happen? Magnetic pulse will be generated and we are getting a false step angle. That is a single step. That is nothing but the angular moment caused by the shaft when single electrical pulse applied to the motor. That is called as a step angle. The first moment, small moment, whatever I'm getting, if I'm like single moment, single signal to the phase winding. That is nothing but the step angle. Now the number of rotor, that is NR, I saw at the type of variable return starting. We represent the number of rotor teeth are NR and number of stator teeth are NS. And number of phases are P in the single stator stack. If number of stator teeth is greater than number of rotor teeth, then relationship will be NS, number of stator teeth is equal to number of rotor teeth plus number of stator teeth per phase. That is nothing but NS upon P. Like a previous case, whatever we discuss over here till now, in this example, okay, number of stator teeth are 8, number of rotor teeth are 6, and number of S by P, number of stator teeth per phase, is 2. 6 plus 2, that is a 8. That is nothing but I am explaining over here. Whatever I explain over here, that is nothing but NS is equal to NR plus minus and S by P. Means 8 is equal to 6 plus 2. Then it satisfies the relationship. Now let's take the example, same diagram I am taking. Here number of rotor teeth are 6. Number of stator teeth are there 8. Then number of S by P, then how many teeth I require the phases, that 2 teeth are required a single phase. Okay, the number of phases are 4. Let's take the next example. Again another example, another types of variable reference motor. Now in this case number of rotor teeth are 8. Okay, now just check 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. And number of stator teeth are 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Then in this case, if I am substituting these two value, 12, 8, then N S by P, number of stator teeth per phase, I am getting 4. Means for the single phase, I required 4 teeth. Then just check here, A, again A, again A, and again A. In single winding, I am wounding on a 4 teeth of stator. Okay, in this case I'm required the three phase winding, 1, 2, 3, A, B, C. In this case I required four phase, but in this case I required three phase because of this relationship. In this manner I'm designing the stepper motor based on this relationship. Okay, next, after that, the rotor and stator pitch angle theta and theta s are defined as, theta is nothing but 360 divided by nr and theta s is equal to 360 divided by ns. That is nothing but number of rotor teeth, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Sorry, rotor teeth are 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 360 divided by 6. The pitch angle between the rotor is 60 degree, theta is 60 degree and stator, theta s, stator teeth angle, that is 360 divided by 8, that is 45 degree. The angle between two teeth are 45 degree. Now number of step angle between the motor for the one revolution, 360 degree. How many steps is required to complete? In this, just starting the variable reluctance, at that time I explained it, to complete the rotation for this motor is required 24 steps to complete one revolution. From where that 24 value I'm getting? From this formula, S is equal to nrp equal to nr into ns divided by ns minus nr. You can use any one of the formula, you're getting the same answer. Nr is nothing but number of rotor teeth. Here number of rotor teeth are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Number of phases are 4. 6 into 4, 24. For this motor, it required 24 steps. Suppose if you are taking this example, in this example, how many steps are required? Now number of rotor teeth are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 and number of faces are 3. 8 into 3. 8 threes are, again, for this motor also it is required 24 steps. Even though combinations are different, but I require the same step angles. And last, the step angle in degree, if it is required, it given by 360 divided by number of step. Okay, 360 divided by, as in this case I required 24 step, here also I required 24 step, then 360 divided by 24. In the both the motor I'm getting in the full step mode 15 degree step angle. And one more formula is there. Suppose I required number of phase per pitch, number of teeth per pitch for the stator. If you need to find out n s by p, then if you know s and p, in that case s divided by p bracket p minus 1 if stator teeth is greater than rotor teeth. If it is less than, stator teeth is greater than stator teeth is less than rotor teeth, in that case the formula will be s divided by p bracket p plus 1. And these are the formulas we can use to design the stator motor. If you are not getting exactly what I'm explaining over here, if you want to learn in detail the content I explained till now, then you can refer the Applied Mechatronics, a Smiley and FMOD book, Oxford University. I refer the same book, and from this book I made this PPT and I'm giving the explanation by referring the same book. Okay. Thank you very much for watching my this video. The test will be appear very soon. Right now the test link is not available. Just check the description box in future. The test link will be available. Just appear the test. If you are getting more marks, more than 80%, then no need to rewatch this video. Yes, you understand each and every content properly. But if you are getting less marks, less than 50%, that case rewatch this video. Okay, go through it once again properly. After reappear the test, if you are getting more than 80%, that means you got the content properly. You can check my introduction of mechatronics, the video. The link is available over here. Okay. Also, you can click on this card icon. You can check this link in description box also. And the introductory part regarding second series, what exactly the content I'm going to explain in briefly explain in this 2.0 video. The link also is available in description. Please share this video, like kijiye, apne friend log ke saath share kijiye ye video, and hit the subscribe button please to motivate me to make such video in future. Hit the like button, share it with your friends, and if you have any doubt, comment, feedback, positive, negative, please mention in comment box. This video mein yahi tak, hum fir milenge ek naye video ke sath. Thank you very much. Bye bye, take care.